Viel Spaß! Hier ist die jetzt für Sie, Broken Circle Breakdown Bluegrass Band!
Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day, when I saw the hearse come rolling for to carry my mother away. Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home away. Undertaker, undertaker, please drive slow. For this body you are holding, Lord, Lord, I hate to see her go. Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting.
Thank you. Vielen Dank, vielen Dank. So, I'm first going to introduce somebody. You know, we all want to be a cowboy, everyone here on stage, from when we were 6 years old. But there's only one person here who succeeded in doing that. And that's the guy who made me look good as a banjo player. And he's standing right here, trying to be as modest as possible with a red suit on. Mr. Carl Eriksson. Vielen Dank, vielen Dank. Now I'm going to introduce another guy, and he's the son of this guy, and that's amazing. In Belgium the music sold like for 16 weeks. It was number one in the top charts CD thing, and it is the best selling soundtrack ever in Belgium, and it beat Titanic. yeah, that's amazing. It's great, and it has put country and bluegrass music on the map in Belgium, and we're very proud of that. And you know, and there's one person particularly who's responsible for that, who made the arrangements, who put all those musicians together, and we rehearsed, and he took all the decisions, and he's one of the best dobro players in Europe, certainly in Belgium. And his name is Björn Eriksson.
Thank you. traveling through this world of woe. Yet there's no sickness, toil or danger in that bright world to which I go. I'm going there to see my Father. I'm going there no more to roam. I'm only going over Jordan. I'm only going over home. I know dark clouds will gather around me. I know my way is rough and steep, yet beautiful fields lie just before me, where God's redeemed their vigils keep. I'm going to eat meat, meat when I come. I'm only going over Jordan. I'm only going over home.
Thank you.
A big applause for the Nachtigall from Belgium, Veerle Baters. Ah, amazing. Okay, now we're going to put some tempo back in it, and we're going to play the song in the movie where she falls in love with my character. Mm. Her character falls in love with my character. And it's very romantic. He's in a bar, and she comes in, and he plays this song. It's called Cowboy Man. It's by Lai Lovett. And he's an amazing singer-songwriter, and And he was once married by Julia Roberts, but that's not important. You should check it out if you don't know him. It's amazing. But
excuse me, I do want to say, because they're all laughing, he's in love with Julia Roberts.
Yeah, I am. I think she's an amazing actress, and it's not because she's mainstream that she's not a good actress. She's amazing. let's get clear about that. But still, you know, and it's very, very romantic in the movie, but, you know, if you listen to the lyrics, it's not that romantic. It just, it's the story of a boy, and there's a woman who comes up to him and says, you know what, if you fuck me hard once in a while, I will clean up after you for the rest of your life. So it's just a man's dream, basically. It's called Cowboy Man. She wore glass slippers, she held head up high. She had that sparkle at her feet and that twinkle in her eye. She smiled at me, and as I wondered why, she said,
I'm looking for a cowboy.
Yeah! Take me for a ride, and
he can roll
me on the prairie. He can ride me on the plane, and I will be
a Cinderella
if you'll be my cowboy man. She said, I got a 40-gallon Stetson hat with a 38-foot brim. We could dance around the outside, baby, till we both fall in. And
you can roll
me on the prairie. You can ride me on the plane. And I will be
a Cinderella
if you'll be my cowboy man.
Hit it!
Ain't never been no cowboy, but heaven knows I tried. I'll be riding tall in my saddle, honey, with that Cinderella by my side. And I can roll her on the prairie, and I can ride her on the plain. She will be
my Cinderella,
and I'll be her cowboy man. And
I will roll
her on the prairie, and I will ride Cinderella, and I'll be her cowboy man. Vielen Dank. Danke. Danke schön. You know, in bluegrass music, every third song has to be a white gospel. Has to be about, it's tough down here, but one day we will be at the pearly gates. We will be at the gates of heaven, and then we will be happy for the rest, for eternity. And every third song has to be about that. And there's some beautiful songs, full of heart and devotion. And I love them very much. I'm not a religious guy, but I love it still. So we're gonna do one now. It's called Glory Land.
Thank you.
Have a home prepared where the saints abide, over in the glory land. And I long to be by my Savior's side, over in the glory land, just over in the glory land. What a joyful thought that my Lord I'll see over in the glory land. And the kindred say that forever I'll be over in the glory land. Just over in the glory land, I'll join the happy angel band over in the glory land.
Before I was part of this project, I really didn't like country music. I know there are a lot of country lovers in the room, but I didn't. I'm sorry. For me, it was the kind of music they put on bad weddings, and the drunk uncles got to the DJ and they say, "Oh, can we have that?" Yeah. But then I got in, and I had to learn the guitar. I'm a bad player, but the lovely thing about bluegrass, about country music, is that even with three chords, you can play, and even in the back of, you will see some of that later on, me playing in the back with a guitar. And my guitar teacher, he gave me a CD with all these kind of songs, and there was one song on it, and it was a song of Dolly, and I didn't like her either. But then I got to know her, and actually she's one of the greatest musicians I've ever seen and I heard about, and when I hear her sing, it's incredible. So yeah, I'm honored that I can sing a song that she wrote and that she sings and that she plays with her long fingernails on the guitar. Yeah, so here it is. One, two, three.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna introduce another guy. You know, I'm sure that here in Germany there's a very exciting bluegrass thing going on, and there's probably a lot of semi-professional, amateur bluegrass musicians out there, and who do a great job, and sometimes are as good as the American guys, and it's incredible what talent Europe has, and also in Belgium we have some bands, and one of the bands is called Rawhide, and it's chosen to be the best European bluegrass band this year. Yeah. So, and one of those guys who plays in Rawhide is we just took him along because he's so an amazing mandolin player and a good guitar player, Bert van Bortel. Now we're gonna do a song a little bit more up tempo. it's a classic. Everybody plays it in bluegrass mitts. There's an amazing thing. Ricky Skaggs had a fantastic version of it. It's called Little Maggie, and it's a typical bluegrass song. It's about a guy who thinks his girlfriend drinks a lot lately, and she has a gun and she plays the banjo. It's a little bit weird. She likes other guys, and she's probably very unhappy. But at the end of the song, he throws her out anyway. That's the hard bluegrass life for you there. So it's called Little Maggie.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, you understand, little Maggie, with a brim glass in her hand. She's drinking away her trouble. She's courting another man. Last time I saw little Maggie, she was sitting on the banks of the sea with a 44 around her and a banjo her on her knee. Pretty flowers were made for blooming. Pretty stars were made to shine. Pretty women were made for loving. Little Maggie was made for mine. Lay down your last gold dollar. Lay down your gold watch and chain. Little Maggie's gonna dance for daddy. Listen to that old banjo ring. Go away, little Maggie. Go and do the best you can. Gonna get me another woman. You can get your another man. Yeehaw! Oh. Man, that's so much fun. You should all learn to play the banjo or the mandolin or the guitar. It's really fun. It's fun to do. It's just so amazing. And you're in a poor theater group. We write a play, and then you learn to play the banjo and a little bit the guitar, and then all of a sudden, I'm here in Essen with the best musicians of Belgium and the Nightingale of Flanders, and it's such a present. Thank you very much, everybody. Once in a while, you have to do an instrumental thing. And does anyone play the banjo in this? No, there must be somebody. Yeah. Yeah. But you know, when you learn to play the banjo and we all buy the book of Earl Scruggs. You know, Earl Scruggs was the godfather of the banjo because for the first time he started picking it with three finger style, and so he died last year. And but we all buy the book, and then after a while, after a few years, you this goes and you learn all the songs, and then all of a sudden you turn a page and there's another tuning. And then you realize that there's like 25 tunings for the banjo, but the first other tuning you meet is the D tuning. Normally it's all in G tuning. And the song that is written there is an instrumental, and it's a signature piece for Earl Scruggs because he played it for the first time with the banjo. It's amazing. And it's called Reuben Strain. And it's what's particular about that song is two things. First of all, sorry that I like to talk, but first of all, it's about a train, and there's a lot of train things going on in country and bluegrass music because in the beginning of the 20th century, a lot of the guys from Kentucky, the farmer, it didn't work out, and they left home and they went like immigrants. They went to Detroit and to Chicago to work in the steel mines and the coal mines and the steel factories and the car factories. And what happened was that the people who stayed home, they just watched the trains coming and hoping that their loved ones should be on it. And the guys who were there, who were very homesick because everybody laughed at them because they were hillbillies and they talked funny with a funny accent. And they all just had, and they prayed that one day I will take a train and it will carry me back home. That's why a train is so much a symbol, and it's called Reuben's Train. And what's particular about that song is that it's one chord. It's a there's a seven chord in there, but basically it's a one chord song, and we're gonna play it right now.
Thank you. The problem was there was a scene where some of the actors, well, one actor had to cut his hair. And he didn't want to. So they all looked at me and they said, well, you wear a wig and then you pull it off, it's easy. So I wore a wig for about 2 months. You know, they put real glue on that thing, you know? And I came home at night and the glue was still on and I couldn't take off my glasses anymore. And I had to sleep with my glasses. And anyway, they cut the scene. It's not in there, I mean. So, 2 months with a wig and glue. But I love movie making, it's great. Yeah.
You know what also amazing, when it's a success like that, and sometimes I'm in my car and I turn on my radio and there's a song on and it's us guys, and you know, I'm on the radio, I always want to pull over and then I call my mother and say, Mom, I'm on the radio, and then she's always too late because okay, next time, Ma, and the song I hear then on that radio, it's always the same song, and it's the most beautiful song ever written. It's written by Towns Van Zandt. Yeah. Yahoo! I'm a big Towns Van Zandt fan. It's the best singer-songwriter ever, and this song in particular, it's about, the movie's about the song, and the song is about the movie, and he didn't realize it, Towns, that I just was going to write the whole play about it and a movie. And it's my number one hit in Belgium. It's called If I Needed You.
Since I showed her how to lay her lily hands in mine, and who would not agree, she's a sight to see and the treasure for the poor.
If I need you, would you come to me? would swim the seas for to ease your pain.
You know, it's been a long evening for you, and we're gonna do the last song of this evening, and what we're not gonna do is we're not going to go off, and then you will we will not come back, and because to me, I'm an actor. It's very strange. It's musicians do this thing, and for me it's like after a play you go off and then they clap and you have to return and you do to be or not to be. That's another monologue or something like that, and that's very strange. So we're not going to do the musicians thing. We're just gonna do the last song, and it's an instrumental song, and it's also the last song of the movie. But before we do that, I still have to talk about one person, and you all noticed him. You know, we all try to be cowboys. There are a lot of cowboys here, and there are cowgirl, but there's one Indian, and he's behind me. He's the bass player, and he's an amazing guy. He's very famous. Zita Swoon, Think of One in Flanders, and we're lucky to have him. And his name is Thomas Smet. So we're gonna do the song, instrumental song, in which we say goodbye to Elise, and we will say goodbye to you with this song, Sand Mountain. Thank you.
Okay, just one more. To be or not to be. We're gonna do a song. It's called Salty Dog. It's by the Morris Brothers, who had a garage, and they had a big success with it for 2 years. But then they returned to the garage, and it's about, you know, I didn't know what a salty dog was until a girl in Brussels told me. And a salty dog apparently is somebody, a sailor who was on sea a long time and then returned home to his wife with a lot of with his tongue hanging on the ground and his skin smelling and tasting of salt. A salty dog. Staying in the corner with a low down blues, great big hole in the bottom of my shoes.
Honey, let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog, or I won't be no man at all. Honey, let me be your salty dog.
Pull trigger and guns and go, shot from over in Mexico.
And let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog, or I won't be your man at all. And let me be your salty dog.
Now look here, Sal, I know you. Running, stuck in, wore my shoe.
And let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog, or I won't be your man at all. Or let me be your salty dog.
Down in the wild, we'll still in love. Trick on the finger and eye and bar.
And let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog, or I won't be no man at all. Or let me be your salty dog.
Hello, my name is Johnny Cash.
And let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog, or I won't be your man at all. And let me be your salty dog.
Sleep, you little baby. Your mama's gone away and your daddy's gonna stay. Didn't leave nobody but the baby. Go to sleep, you little baby. Go to sleep, you little baby. Everybody's gone in the cotton and the corn. Didn't leave nobody but the baby. You're a sweet little baby.
You're a sweet little baby.
You're a sweet little baby.
You're a sweet little
honey in the rock and the sugar don't stop. Gonna bring a bottle to the baby. Don't you weep, pretty baby.
Don't you weep, pretty baby.
Don't you weep, pretty baby.
Don't you weep, pretty baby.
She's long gone with her red shoes on. Gonna need another loving baby. Go to sleep, you little baby.
Go to sleep, you little baby.
Go to sleep, you little baby.
Go to sleep, you little baby.
You and me,
the devil makes three.
Don't need no other loving baby.
Go to sleep, you